Celebrity real estate agent and media personality Raven Tao is this week's guest judge. As an ambassador for renowned luxury realtors Engel and Volker, Raven understands firsthand the importance interior design has on the value of a home, and she'll be judging the teams accordingly.
Well, if ever there was a challenge, it was this one. A bathroom with a theme of eras.
Yes, yes. It was boot camp, and by thunder did we start sorting out the wheat from the chaff. What did you think, Raven?
Frankly, it was really interesting to see the difference that came out from the different personalities and how far some people would really go all in with their commitment to design.
Right, let's start with Nara and Perlin. This particular team, Nara and Perlin, were very, very, very much at the bottom last week.
Yes, they were.
And we had to have tough words with them.
I like that it was bold. I like that they really went and did a lot of contrasting.
But you know what? They got the functionality part of this right too this week. You know, they created that beautiful bespoke cabinet underneath the vanity there.
Yeah.
It was beautiful.
Now, this is our only male team. There's certainly a lot of mojo going on with the Ziggy bathroom.
The colour choice was great. I wasn't too sure about the execution of the concrete.
I agree with you, execution wasn't there.
No.
This is where I almost fell into the shower because the floor didn't quite reach it. Okay, let's see what judging.
I think that's their policy. I think there was a lady trap.
It was a bit hazardous though.
You're not that enamoured?
No, I'm not at all.
No.
No, I just think it's almost but not quite.
No. This was an interesting one for me.
Yes, wasn't it?
Because this was actually custom made. Yeah. You might notice that that's actually their initials.
Yes, I love that wall, really clever. But that little cabinet under the basins was exquisite.
We learned from the last time.
You are learning from the last time, which makes me feel good because there's nothing I want more than to rub off on you. And I love the red. It's the second red bathroom that we've had. And I always think that red is a very, very good colour for bathrooms because you get a lot of light bouncing off onto your complexion, you look much nicer, you look much fresher. And bathrooms tend to have too much white in them, so red is a good antidote.
Yeah.
So we're now skidding on to Sarah and Brian. Great Gatsby-inspired bathroom.
I like that they tied in the detail of the 1920s Malaysian photographs in the gold gilding.
Yes, really clever, right. Really clever.
Lovely.
Well, they're a very, very thoughtful team, but they are still too cluttered. It's like they've done a nice room and then they've got Auntie to come round with a bag of knickknacks from home. Right, now we have the lovely Denki and Tiara.
I like it in some ways. I think in the fact that the colour scheme is quite simple, black and white, but I hate the sticker.
I mean, I agree with you. I mean, I don't really understand that sticker, but then those mirrors are lovely.
Yes, they are.
You know, the mirrors are perfect then. Actually, Denki and Tiara, in an incredibly understated way, made something more powerful by doing a real exercise in less is more. And we now move on to an experience.
I didn't really feel like they quite captured what they were going for with the 60s thing.
You know, these two artificial flowers either side there, like it's some sort of, you know, dinky little blind.
Now look, the rug was really, really a bad choice.
Oh my God, well, I keep getting drawn to these ropes. Are they washing lines? Are these washing lines on the ceiling?
Could be. It's just a divider. It's originally, sometimes people use these as dividers.
You know those kind of traveller hotels, those kind of, you know, salesman hotels where you get a washing line, so you can rinse your pants out and your socks and hang them out to dry. What I will say is that they do have a very, very good eye for colour, because actually those colours do sit quite well together. They just have been not terribly thought out.
It just didn't quite get there, did it?
At all.
I think it was a long way from getting there. Now, Yvette and Sonia.
It was very quirky, girly and lovely in so many ways.
I have to say that I was terribly disappointed in that.
Really?
I think it's exquisite, I think it's beautiful, I think it's chic, I think it's perfect, and it has got no soul. It has got no heart, and they haven't even tried. What I don't like is the fact that we haven't got a sense of Yvette. That's what Yvette and Sonia are actually like. Then, they are replicants, and they will probably take their rubber faces off to reveal the fact that they're lizards. Right, now, as a grand finale, Priyanka and Vineet.
As an agent in real estate, if I took a client to see this, they'd probably be quite confused about what's going on.
They're an interesting team. They've got a lot to say.
Yeah, we are trying to show the film industry what people were trying to...
That's Marilyn, who was the icon for that.
And of course, here we are trying to show...
That was the American Diner's area, where there were checkered floors, and we wanted to put it there, but we did not want the same partner to come here.
Blimey. It feels to me as if it is a series of bits and pieces that have been rather thrown into the space.
You've got an early century phone, you've got a scrubbing brush, some shoeboxes, and a couple of 1980s mirrors.
It is the what's left over room.
Look, in my opinion, in this competition right now, there are two clear front runners.
Right.
Who the back runners are is to be decided. So let's bring them back in and we'll find out who goes home.
Coming up.
Do you understand the gravity of a small mistake like that?
Another team's dreams comes crashing down.
Put in your key. We are losing you.
Next.